Navy joins the American this year after playing as an independent for the last 134 seasons. They'll play in the West Division with Houston, Memphis, SMU, Tulane, and Tulsa. Navy went 8-5 last season, marking the 11th time in 12 years that the midshipmen finished with at least 8 wins. Navy has made 10 bowl appearances in the last 11 seasons as well. One of the key stories in the American this season will be how well Ken Niumatalolo's triple option offense fares in a West Division, which will be stacked with teams prepared to defend wide-open passing schemes. Quarterback Keenan Reynolds enters his senior year with 64 career rushing touchdowns, the most in NCAA history by a quarterback, and fourth all-time among all FBS players. The NCAA record of 77, currently held by Monty Ball, is certainly within reach. Reynolds will rely heavily on senior slot backs DeBrandon Sanders and Demon Brown in the team's run-oriented offense. While the midshipmen boast a top 30 offense, they also have a defense on the rise. The mids are also predictably disciplined, committing the fewest penalties in the nation last year. It was the fourth time in the last 6 years that Navy was the nation's least penalized team. The defense has 6 returning starters from last season, including defensive end Will Anthony, who led the way with 11 tackles for loss in 2014. Taking a look at the 2015 schedule, Navy will write history September 19th as they host their first ever conference game. That one will be against East Carolina. The road slate features trips to Notre Dame, Memphis, which on paper was the only team better than Navy in the conference last season, and Houston. To get to know the midshipmen better, we have Bill Wagner from the Annapolis Capitol on the phone. That's up next. Welcome back. We're now joined on the phone by Bill Wagner, the college sports editor at the Capitol newspaper. He's been covering the Naval Academy for 15 years. Thanks for taking the time to talk to us today, Bill.
My pleasure.
Historic year for Navy with football joining the American Athletic Conference. What should American fans know about the midshipmen?
Well, obviously the very first thing to know is they've been a very successful program now for about 12 years, ever since Paul Johnson became the head coach and installed the triple option offense, and they have a very complementary defensive scheme that works well with their ball control style offense. And then Ken Niumatalolo succeeded Paul Johnson after he left for Georgia Tech and has kept the ball rolling. And this is a very successful program. Bowl games in 11 out of 12 seasons, that's pretty darn successful.
Quarterback Keenan Reynolds has put up impressive stats in his career. What can we expect to see from him this season?
Well, Keenan Reynolds is a special talent. He has been a four-year starter at the Naval Academy. He actually took over as the starting quarterback 5 games into his freshman season. An injury to Trey Miller, the starting quarterback that year, forced Keenan Reynolds into the game against Air Force, and he led a major comeback victory in Colorado Springs, and he's been the quarterback ever since. He's a great fit for the triple option offense. He's a very intelligent quarterback, so he knows how to read defenses, knows where to get the ball in the triple option offense, but he's also a very fine passer. He can throw the ball on target. He's got a strong arm. Just a very unique talent for the Naval Academy. He'll probably go down as one of the best quarterbacks in Naval Academy history, right up there with the legendary Roger Staubach.
Like you mentioned, Navy's system isn't one team see too often. What makes it so hard to defend?
The triple option is, like you said, very unique. And just to digress a second, this is part of what will be interesting about Navy's entrance into the American Athletic Conference. Part of why Navy's option has been so difficult to defend is that every opponent on their schedule only saw it once a year, and often it might be the first time they've seen it in many years. So now Navy's going to be playing opponents on a regular basis. I am sure that the other American Athletic Conference schools are going to build triple option into the practice. Learning how to defend the triple option will be built into their practice routines if they're going to be playing Navy on a regular basis. And it'll be interesting to find out if the unique element of the triple option remains that way after Navy's been in the league for several years. But that's the key. You don't see it very often. Defenses are not accustomed to defending that type of offense. They're accustomed to defending these spread passing attacks or maybe power running games. And it's just a complete change of philosophy. And you've got to try to train your defenders in 1 week how to defend something that they don't see that often. So It's, and Navy, of course, runs this at the highest level. There are very few schools in the history of NCAA football have ever run the triple option with the precision at which Navy runs it.
How do you expect Navy to match up against the teams in the West?
Well, it's interesting. When initially Navy joined this conference, it was the old Big East Conference with a different lineup, of course. And, the thought was that this could be a real challenge. But what's interesting about the makeup of the American Athletic Conference now is that many of the new members of the conference are schools that Navy is accustomed to playing over the years. They have played SMU. They have played Tulsa. They have played East Carolina. They have played Tulane. So these are schools that Navy has played in the past that they feel they are comparable with. And, frankly, somewhat like-minded institutions. When you're talking about an SMU and a Tulane, they're high academic schools, and that's part of why Navy scheduled those schools back when they did, because they felt they were somewhat like-minded institutions. So I think Navy can do very well. I've watched Navy beat a lot of good opponents over the years. I've seen them, crush Missouri in a bowl game. I've seen them beat Stanford badly on its home field. So... nothing to me, Navy is capable of beating anyone, but what head coach Nick Kenyamatalolo will tell you, they're also capable of losing to anyone, because there's a very fine line with the Naval Academy. They are going to be smaller, slower, not as strong. They don't have the same caliber athletes, even though they have improved their recruiting and they have improved their talent base. They still are never going to be able to match up athletically with most Division I schools. So there's a fine margin for error with Navy, and they've got to play flawlessly. They've got to not make mistakes. They can't beat themselves with penalties and turnovers and such. That's kind of been the story with Navy. If you look at their schedule over the years, they always play four or five games that are a touchdown separation either way. And that's just the way it is with Navy. They're going to play close games, and they're going to count on the fact that they are going to be able to win those close games by playing good, sound, fundamental football.
First trip for a lot of these teams to Annapolis. What's the game day atmosphere like at the Academy?
Well, it's, I think, one of the finest game day atmospheres you'll find anywhere in the country. It's rather unique when you've got F-18 fighter jets going overhead prior to kickoff. And they have the march on of the Brigade of Midshipmen. I think the American Athletic Conference fans from other schools are going to be very, very eager to come to Navy and see the old pageantry of Navy football game. And Annapolis is a wonderful town. We're located within a half hour either way of Washington and Baltimore, so you've got two great cities. I think for American Athletic Conference fans at these other schools, they would be very wise to attend the game in Annapolis.
Would you say the American Championship game is a realistic goal for the midshipmen this year?
I think the Navy is, they have put that on their goal list. The Navy goals are always the same. Beat Air Force and Army, capture the Commander-in-Chief trophy. That's the number one goal, always will be. Number two goal has been to go to a bowl game. Well, now they've added a third goal, and that's to capture the American Athletic Conference Championship. If they end up in the championship game, it's going to make things very difficult, because Navy has always had a two-week break prior to its end-of-season rivalry game against Army. If they play in the American Athletic Conference Championship game, they will not get that break. They'll be playing the conference championship game the week before Army. But I think that they would be more than happy to take the inconvenience in order to be in that championship game.
Well, I know we're excited to have Navy in the conference. Thanks again for taking the time to talk to us today, Bill.
Absolutely my pleasure.
Again, Bill Wagner, college sports editor at the Capital Newspaper. Navy kicks off their season at home September 5th against Colgate before their first conference game on September 19th against East Carolina. For the American Digital Network, I'm Haley Outen. Have a great day.